Hey, hey, and welcome to this new episode of What Is on the Climabyte. Today, we will talk about a very important tool in geoscience, photogrammetry. What is photogrammetry?
I have no idea.
It has something to do with visual representations because of the word photo.
You're like using photographs.
Yeah.
To measure things.
And maybe measuring things by looking at pictures of them.
Exactly.
Yay!
Perfect. In a sentence, well, photogrammetry is the method that uses photography, that's the photogra part of the word, to measure distances, that's the metry part of the word. But have you encountered it before? Probably not the tool itself, but you've seen the result of it if you ever use something like Google Earth or Google Maps. How does it work then? Well, if you have an object that is seen by two cameras from two different points of view, you can estimate its position. Your eyes are doing that all the time. There's two of them, after all. But of course, computers can use more than two points of view to reconstruct a model, either to improve the accuracy or to construct a model of something that can't be framed into a single pair of pictures. Any kind of camera can be used for photogrammetry, from your smartphone to a professional digital camera, or even specialized system mounted on planes, or even satellites. With photogrammetry, we can compute the position of objects that are seen on two or more images. If we cover a whole area with pictures, then we can compute a 3D model of the whole thing. Using that, we can compute an ortho image. An ortho image, you say? Well, it's an image that can be overlaid on a map. For instance, if I have this small hill and a cliff, I can pretend to be a plane, fly over it to make a 3D model and a map of it. I then take one picture and then another, and I make sure that every point of my hill and my cliff are seen in at least two pictures. Good. With these pictures, I can create the 3D model. From this 3D model, I can extract the ortho image. The 3D information allows to correct for the difference in perceived size. For instance, on the original image, you see that the house on the top of the cliff looks a lot bigger than the house on the bottom of the cliff, simply because the house on the top of the cliff is closer to the camera than the house on the bottom. On the ortho image, you can see they are exactly the same size. So, when do we use photogrammetry? Well, for instance, we can use it to get models of small archaeological artifacts or buildings, or even to make the whole map of a country. Also, it's the technology that's behind 3D movies. But how do we use it in geoscience? Well, having 3D models of things like volcanoes is very useful to be able to understand how they move, how they change, and even maybe predict eruptions. We also use it to see how landslides or glaciers are moving and sliding. It can also be used to study very weird phenomena, like rock circles forming in permafrost. So, photogrammetry. Probably not a tool you've heard about before, but a very important one in geoscience. I hope you've learned a climabyte thing today. If you have, push a like button. You can also share this video with your friends, and if you have more questions, you can contact us through the comments or on our Twitter account. If you want to learn more climabyte things, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I'll see you next time.